Hey guys, it's Craig at Area 419. I have in front of me one of the brand new Collis K525i DLR models. They've just released them. They're going to start being available to the public in the spring. And I want to give you some first impressions on this. We're going to get it out to the range. We'll talk to you some more about that in the coming days. But the first major noticeable difference on the unit is the size of the elevation turret. I don't think they've actually grown it significantly, but what they did do that made a lot of difference for me is they went to a 10 mil turret as opposed to a 13 or a 14 they had on the original model. This means you've got fewer clicks per revolution, and that means you get more visibility to each of those quick clicks. They're more tactile, you get more space between them, and it's going to leave you more sure of exactly where you are. I know that one of the things that I would struggle with on my 624s or the 525s that are currently on my rifles is sometimes I wouldn't be totally sure. Am I at 2.4 mils or 2.5 or 2.6 to 2.7? You could get lost in some of these clicks. So by reducing this to a 10 mil turret, you've got more space between clicks. They're easier to feel. They're easier to see. I think it's a cool improvement for the product. The other thing that they talk about is I think the biggest improvement they could have made on the existing 525s, and that is field of view. They're advertising an 8% increase in field of view. Now, 8% is not huge, but when you start talking about how fast you can find that target when it's out in the field, how many more things you can see, whether it's a little tree or bush at the edge of your sight picture that's giving you an indication of what's happening with wind, that 8% can make a big difference. So like I said, we're going to get this on a gun, get it out to the range, do some side-by-side stuff, and give you a more used technical analysis. But for now, I'm excited about what they've done. I'm glad they've made a step forward, especially with the turret and field of view, and we'll see how it pans out. So until next time, thanks for stopping by.